Number 1. Picking his favorite tattoo is impossible. After his big night, a fan tweeted at Reaves and said, "If Reaves retweets this, then I will get a tattoo of him." Reaves replied and said, "Make sure you get it of my good side." Reaves had a bunch of tattoos of his own and said he can't single out which one is most special to him. That's a tough question, but almost everyone has something behind it. He says, "I have one for my son Kane I just got, which I really like. I have one for almost each of my 3 buddies that died. I have my journey in hockey. They're all very special to me. They all have a story." Number 2. He used to box all the time. For anyone who was wondering where he got that right hook he pummeled McLeod with, Reeves said he started to box around his first AHL season. "That was because I really fought before," said Reeves, who's listed at 6'1 and 225 pounds. "I wasn't really a fighter when I got drafted, but I played very physical, and that's kind of what turned me into somebody who had to fight, because you had to answer the bell. You had to protect guys." That summer, he would go at least 2 or 3 times a week, and the next season. "I fought everything that moved," Reaves says. As the game has changed, Reaves boxes a lot less, but still does it every now and then, especially since it's an unbelievable cardio workout. Number 3. He's terrified of sharks in the ocean. Reaves may be a tough guy on ice, but not in the water. "Here's my argument," Reaves says. "When was the last time you saw a fish come on land and mess with a human? Why would I go in the ocean and mess with a fish?" He went on to tell this hilarious story about swimming in Jamaica during an all-star break. He and his wife Alana went on this little cruise, and while they were there, everybody decided to go snorkeling in the middle of the ocean. At first, Reaves was just going to stay on the boat and relax, but when he realized that he was the only one not going, he grudgingly agreed to go. "I just figured I'm going to get in the water and I'm going to stay in a group with everybody, and if sharks come, they're going to work their way from the outside and I'll be the last. Hopefully they'll be full by that time," he laughed. So Reaves got into the water, which was pretty deep, started swimming, and felt something brush his leg. Somebody told him that there were a bunch of fish right under him, and Reaves thought that person was messing with him because they knew he hated fish. "But I look under there, and there are 1,000 fish near me. I put the goggles up like, I'm just going to chill. They're just tiny fish, and don't worry about it. Act natural. They can smell fear." Then 2 minutes later, some guy comes out of nowhere snorkeling by himself and was like, "Hey everybody, come over here. There's a stingray." And in my head, I was like, wait, a stingray killed Steve Irwin. At that time, Reaves said he freaked out. Have you ever seen a wake behind somebody swimming because they were so scared? "I could have pulled skiers, I was so scared," he laughed. "I got out of there so quick it was ridiculous. And that was the last time I ever did that." Fact number 4. Athleticism in the Reaves family doesn't fall far from the tree, as his father Willard is a former professional football player who was actually a member of the Winnipeg Bombers when Ryan was born. And number 5. He's a prankster. Reaves recently scared Kessel out of his skin by creeping up on him suddenly while wearing this mask. It turns out that wasn't the first time he's pranked a fellow teammate. "It's been around for a while," referring to the mask, he says. "I got a couple of guys in St. Louis. I got Kevin Shattenkirk, and I also got Scotty Gomez with the same mask. I wrapped Ian Cole's car in a saran wrap one day. I like to keep it light," Reeves says. And that, he's done for sure.
Your soul is mine.